Okay, hey guys. I wanted to do a short slide presentation on the fundamentals of pistol shooting. Some of my other lessons have this included, but this is just the basic fundamentals of pistol shooting. Many people are new getting into guns, whether you're a revolver shooter, rifle shooter, pistol shooter. There are some fundamentals that I'm going through here to show you. Fundamentals included are aiming. Okay, you have to aim the handgun correctly or gun correctly. Hold control, you have to hold it correctly. You have to have a firm grip. Breath control, you have to not hold your breath or not breathe too much. You can muscles can get actually your muscles can tremble and they can get tired from holding and breathing too much. Trigger control. You want a firm, light trigger control. You don't want to anticipate the shot. Follow through. When you do the first shot, you pull the trigger the same way the second shot. These five fundamentals, if you follow these, every time should work fine. Okay, let's go ahead to the first one, aiming. Aiming, okay, is a process of achieving the proper relationship between the target, the front sight, and their rear sight. So you have three items in there. But mainly, you know, your rear sight and your target are gonna be a little blurry, so you're gonna focus on with your front sight. That needs to be real clear and try to get an equal balance between the both. Now on sight alignment, if you look at this picture here, this is the rear, okay, this is the rear sight, okay? And here is your post, your front post. So that's how it should look. And you're actually, what you're gonna shoot should be right on top of that, okay? You should be right on top of that notch. That's where it should be. Slight alignment refers to the proper relationship of the pistol's front and rear sights. With post and notch sights, the tops of the front and rear sights are even. The front post is centered in the rear notch, just like we have there. So you have that centered, that is the correct sight picture. Now, your sight picture is a proper sight picture is obtained when the aligned sights are put into their proper relationship with the target. So, like the previous picture, see how that's lined up there? So, what you're shooting at, and here in case is the bullseye, he's putting it there. You can have it like this, or you can have it like this. It's going to depend on, it's a 6 o'clock hold, they call this, is the center hold. Okay, it's going to really depend on your gun you're shooting, the recoil, and how you want to work with it. This, I've found, this one here works pretty good with fiber optic sights. And this one with your regular iron sights, I've found, works pretty good. Like I say, there's a 6 o'clock hold and the center hold. These are two. And like I say, you want to refer back to this here. That is what you're looking for. Okay, and of course the 6 o'clock is just right on top, and the center is just what it says. This is centered on there, just like that. Okay. But like I say, now we're going to go in some errors in sight alignment. Errors in sight alignment and sight picture. Now, if you look at A, well, let's just read the description here. Sight alignment is more critical than sight picture. And that's very true. You want to make sure your sights are lined up and correctly. Otherwise, you're not going to hit what you're shooting at. The sight picture error yields an A, a slightly off-center group. A slight alignment error C produces a much larger deviation of the group from the target. Proper sight alignment and picture is B. This is where you want to be. Now that's the 6 o'clock. If you want the center, then that would be, of course, half on that. But you want to make sure your sight, it definitely looks just like this right here. Okay, so I'm going to make sure it looks like that. See, I'm going back to these, kind of gripping through there and showing you. So that is the correct sight alignment. Now the front sight focus. Front sight focus. When shooting a pistol with iron sights, visual focus should be on the front sight. This will leave the target and rear sight slightly fuzzy. As you look here, this is fuzzy, this is fuzzy. You want to focus with your front sight. As shown at the left, but clear enough to establish proper sight alignment and sight picture. So they're showing that, you know, really That's, you know, how you want that to be. Now, what we're doing is I'm just going to sight alignment on this. So I'm going to recap the sight alignment and the aiming. And then I'm going to have another video for hold control. Okay. So here's the aiming. And aiming is a process of achieving a proper relationship. Then we go into the sight alignment. The sight alignment refers to the proper relationship. And that's how you want to look at your sight alignment. Okay. Here's a sight picture. And the sight picture, here's a 6 o'clock in the center hold. Your sight picture, you want the proper sight picture, okay? And this is how you achieve that. And it's dependent on your gun, how much kick you have. Some people like it this way, some it might kick up. I kind of like this for the 22, the center hold. And the 6 o'clock, I kind of like it for the bigger caliber guns because they have a little more hit. When you're shooting, you can kind of get an idea when you're shooting. If you're off to the left, you're off to the right, or what kind of errors you might have. If you have adjustable sights, what I recommend is shoot the way you feel comfortable, close enough, bring the target up, see where you're off, adjust your sight, shoot again, adjust again, shoot again until you get it pretty much. And if you can get it at 15 yards, which is about 45 feet, I think you'd be okay. Once again, here's the front sight focus, and I've gone through this trying to focus myself. Back will be blurry, the bullseye will be blurry, this post here is what you want to be clear. It's not going to be perfect because, you know, your eyes can't adjust to all three of them. It's a progressive type of visual effect. So that's what I wanted to do, and it's basically I'm just going to the aiming, and this was our aiming portion with the sight alignment. This is aiming. You know, like I say, you're going to aim for your sight alignment. So, we've kind of went to sight alignment, sight picture, and errors in sight alignment and sight picture, front sight focus. So, there is hold control, and that's going to be something we're going to talk about next. But I have a separate video up there for that, and I hope this was educational. And like I say, there's different kind of sights that you can actually get. You know, you get fiber optics, you can get laser. Depending on your comfort level, you could decide exactly, you know, what you want and how you want to do it. Okay, thanks a lot, guys, and I hope appreciate it. And I hope this was... Okay, guys, let's go ahead and talk about sight picture here real quick. And you see, this is a bullseye, okay? And this is the rear sight right here of a gun. I'm going to show you a clock in a minute. It's the rear, and this is the front. Well, the first one, you would line up this bullseye right with there for what you want to hit. The second one, you can line it up, is this way, is with it half. And I'm going to do this. I'm only gonna make half of it black. Okay. So figure half. This is your bullseye there, right? And you're half lining it up. See, I'm lining the whole thing up, but you're half lining that up. So if that circle's like that, your sight picture something like this. Okay, something like that. It's half lining up. See. Now, let me go ahead and get a gun here and show you a little bit better. Okay. Let me get a Glock. And we used this in our previous. The Glock is unloaded. It has a light on it. Maybe the light won't make it any better. Okay, so when you're going to aim, actually that's your sight picture you're aiming for. Front and back. Okay, you're wanting... How that's lined up, and I'm going to go ahead and here's your bullseye. And you're going to want when, depending on what you're shooting on, you know, is right below it like that. Okay. Now, you can also have it right on it in the middle, the front half. Now, I'm going to show you with a different gun. And we'll show you that this is empty. And the gun is empty. And this is one with a fiber sight. And you can see the different type of sight. That's a fiber. And you would be lining up same way. There's your sight picture or something like that. Okay. Then we'll go with another gun here. Of course, these are all empty guns. Let's see. This looks empty. And here's another sight picture. And the same thing when you're aiming, you're going to want to have that right on top of there. Okay, or you can have it half like this, but there's a sight picture too. That's the picture you're striving for. Now let's do it with a revolver, which also is empty. Okay, you can't see this good, but there's a red dot there and a black. And you're actually lining that up like that. Okay, same thing. Do it a little bit better. If this focus is good, but you're lining it up right like that. So that kind of gives you some of the ideas. Now, sights are usually adjustable. There's usually a little screw right in here where you can turn, and this will bring it back and forth, or this here will bring it up and down. You can actually line up how you want to line it up on the target there. Okay, but I just wanted to show you those about sight pictures and about sights to make it a little bit more interesting so you can see it. And, you know, sometimes if you see me demonstrating it, it makes it a little bit easier. So thanks a lot.